Where's the queen of spirit now?
Welcome to the Off-Field Drama Podcast. I'm Sauce.
I'm Berkey.
And we're with a very special guest and good pal of mine, Jharal Yow Yeh.
Oh, that's my new name now.
Yeah, how are you, mate?
I'm great, boys. It's absolute Cheers, pleasure mate. To be here. Cheers, yeah. There's nothing wrong with having a schooner while you do a potty as well, and what a better place to do it at than Caco.
I agree.
Yeah.
I agree.
So many great times, actually. Sterling.
Yes.
Not going to call you Saucy. That's not what I call you, Sterling. It's some great times here at the Caxton over the years, and it's good to be back and invited back to do a potty with you, mate.
I wouldn't want it any other way, mate. Both of those things. Good times at the Caxton and potties with you on a Monday and a beer in hand. Very relaxing, I was just saying.
Yeah, it is. I feel very relaxed. And
good.
It's good to be here and so actually I'm going to leave here and remember something. Not, you know, most of the times when I'm here, I'm not in a good way.
We like to make our guests feel relaxed here. We've had Alfie, Charlotte, and we've stooped now to yourself.
Yeah, that's good. You can only go up from here now, James.
What number? Were you a 2 or a 5?
I was a 5.
You're a 5.
Well, if we're talking about what I am, I'm a 10 out of 10, if that's what you're asking. No. Number 5, favourite number ever since I played for the Bronx. And, it's been a lucky number for me over years. Apart from that one time in Perth, it wasn't very lucky for me.
How so lucky?
Hey?
How so lucky?
Okay.
What have you done? What, why has 5 been lucky?
Well, I think the reason why I was so lucky, when I got put in it when I started playing 20s, I just started playing good footy. And I was never really a winger when I sort of come up through the grades straight away. I was more of a fullback to start off with. And then when I went to Cup, when I played for Norse Devils, I was 17 when I debuted for Cup and I was number 2. So I didn't have the best debut for Norse. Kane Manahira was my opposition. Kane Manahira.
Oh, right.
I don't know if you boys remember him, but he was a Bronx. He was with the Broncos at the time. He was massive.
Yeah, right.
Big, big boy. And I was about 75 kilos ringing wet on the wing for Norse. And I didn't play that well in the number 2 jersey. And then, it just got given to me at the Bronx. And obviously some great people come before me and played in that jersey. Big Dell, Wendell Saylor, who, when you get given a jersey like that number, you sort of want to do it justice. So
yeah,
everything else. Me and my wife got married on the 14th, which 1 and 4 is 5.
Oh,
yeah. As well. So just a couple of things off the top of my brain.
We love to make little things like ironies out of numbers here.
Yeah. Yeah.
Did you play any games number 3?
Yes, I did.
Yeah.
I did.
So you're our 3rd guest.
There you go.
Oh,
well,
there
guess
you
what?
Know.
And is this our 12th ep?
12th ep.
So 1 and 2 equals 3.
And that is funny you say that, because my favourite and probably most played, what I've heard of, not that I know, that I've gone and checked, but I wore the number 3 against JT up in town.
Oh, yeah, when you turned him inside out.
Yeah, so I actually think Hodge was supposed to rest that game, but like we all know, Hodge.
Oh, fucking Hodge.
He loves to sit out a couple and one, two, miss a few after Origins, but he came back for that game and I played on the wing in the number 3.
So, where do you reckon Hodge was that night? At a pub watching the game?
No, no, no. He ended up
playing.
He ended up playing because I was supposed to play number 3.
Oh, right. Gotcha.
So, got changed pretty late and thank gosh I didn't play number 3 because Willie Tonga was my opposite number and I had no clue how to play that position at that stage.
Fuck, Willie Tonga was good.
He was a freak.
Oh, he's a gun, mate.
Yeah.
I still, I don't know if anyone's seen Willie Tonga around these days.
He's still jacked.
Can't miss him. He's got baby oil on him all the time. He's always he's cutting off his shirts and they're not singlets. They're literally, he's been cut off. And he's jacked.
Right.
I think he'd be around, he'd be close to 40.
Yeah,
actually,
he would.
I feel disrespectful saying that now, and he's gonna
come after you.
100%. And no one wants baby oil arms coming after you. That's the last thing you do.
Holy shit, man. He was good at Origin.
Oh, that little jink, he had.
Oh.
He had a good fen too.
Yeah.
His fen was super.
He was a soldier too in Origin. I remember when I played with him, he'd fully, dislocated his shoulder and he played out the game.
I heard
the whole game.
Apparently, Lockyer was you need to stay on. Whatever it takes, you need to stay on.
That was 2011, And I think we lost JT that game as well with a knee. The back end of that game was Lockie's last game.
Oh, yeah.
And we ended up wheeling him out.
And JT was in the wheelchair?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I do remember that.
At Suncorp.
At Suncorp Stadium. That was actually, when we were playing those, it was just after the floods. Remember that?
Yeah.
We didn't have any sheds, so we were all set up in the car parks.
Really?
Yeah, right. In dongers, yeah, like showers were in demountables. Yeah. It was a very weird but very cool and memorable if you only just played that year.
Yeah.
Because you couldn't really miss it because it was just after the floods.
I remember the whole stadium was under.
It was up to about level 9 or 10, the seats.
The floor or the pitch was like brown.
Yeah, it was hectic.
And around Milton and stuff.
We were actually doing a preseason for the Broncos and we stopped our preseason because it happened. And we just instead of doing fitness, we went around Red Hill and just helped people with their houses.
That's crazy.
A good touch.
It is. It's very cool. At the time, thought, this is shit. Like, honestly, I was like, I hate this because all I could think about is I'm going to cut myself, get you needed a tetanus shot, I'm going to get infected.
Yeah.
That was my thought process. But, when you step away and because you're just a young man and you're not thinking about others at the time, when you step away and you go, man, that was a pretty cool thing we did. We fully stopped 2 weeks of preseason. To do that for the people of Red Hill. And there were some houses that were just been wiped, completely wiped. And, when you see families, we went out to Ipswich as well and did a lot for them out there as well, which is, now looking back on it, it's like I don't think I'd rather do it any other way. That was pretty cool.
You are a bit precious, aren't you?
A little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah, trying to be.
That's
right. Try not to be.
Yeah.
I think as I've gotten older, I've become a bit more precious. I don't think I would have made a noise about that back then.
Yeah.
Sterling.
But you would now.
But I wouldn't. I probably still wouldn't. No, because I've got different views now because I'm older. I've got kids. I've got a kid.
You've matured.
I've matured a lot. Shit. Well, only when I need to be mature, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah. He acts up sometimes.
I do. I try to.
What, you said you were, it's good to remember here. Can you tell us some stories about you at the CACO? Come on, mate.
Ones that I do remember.
Yeah. Or at least just tell us where you remember up to.
Oh, no, I think the biggest one that stands out for me is having a Mad Monday here. And you would have still been only young fellas, I think, when this happened. This was 11.
Lockie's, so we've been grade 11.
Yeah, 16.
Yeah, so this was Lockie's last year. I think I've told this story once.
You've mentioned, I've heard this.
I think I've told this story once to, yeah, maybe. I'm not sure where I've told it, but.
The shareholders want to hear.
Yeah, the shareholders do want to hear. I was probably drunk that as well. No, it was right here. It was actually right underneath us because everyone would know where we're sitting here at the CACS, and right underneath us is, what do you call that bar? That's
the cauldron.
The cauldron bar.
Yeah.
I still remember it was a Monday. We just lost to Manly down south, and if everyone does remember, Darren Lockyer is, only, 500 metres from here, got kneed in the face by Jared Beale and fractured his face.
Yeah.
And wasn't able to play in that game. So what they did, because he couldn't fly, because he just had an operation, he couldn't go to altitude
because
it would ruin what he just done. So they booked him a helicopter like an Uber, right? He's jumped in the helicopter. And he flew all the way to Sydney to watch us because he wanted to be there, obviously, as the captain and his last. And obviously, if he'd missed if we didn't win, which, we didn't.
Yeah.
Mm. Spoiler alert. That he wanted to be with us, or he wanted to be there to give us some good words of, wisdom.
Well, he's the skipper.
He's the skipper.
And a legend last year.
Going into his game, Matt Gillette actually was in the 5-8 in his role.
Fucking Gillo.
Yeah. And he was still killed it too. By the way. Still killed it, by the way.
That's great.
Oh no, that's all right. That's okay. Oh, that's a carton too. When you get a phone call on a potty, so I'll be looking forward to that.
Carton of what,
bloke?
Yeah, there you go.
I'll just plug. be giving back my own product. Thank you.
He's giving a plug there.
Didn't need it.
Free of charge.
The old boys ruined it. That's your old man, obviously.
I can't believe that a helicopter can go from Brisbane to Sydney.
Well, it's not supposed to.
Yeah.
They had one stop, I think, to fill up again.
Right.
And they just stay on the coast and it just goes.
Fuck, that'd be a nice flight.
But just on the coastline.
Yeah, just straight. Yeah. So not a bad gig for, Lockie. But obviously on the way back, we got on a chartered flight back to Brizzy. So we're all pretty, yeah.
You're well on your way.
How you doing?
Yeah.
How you going? And I do remember we were right here in the cauldron bar and we're all fairly up it and someone goes, everyone out on the front row on the Caxton Street. So we run outside. It's about 11 o'clock, I think. And we look up here. There is Lockie hanging out the helicopter there going, you! Like, I don't know how far up he was, but he was, you know. Yeah. And I just couldn't believe. Like, I was thinking to myself, if this is rugby league, I just want it in my life for the rest of my life.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, the great man has flew back in a helicopter. I mean, to put a bit of GST, there's probably cans falling out of the helicopter. just to add a little bit.
Just little Goldie grenades?
Yeah. I could probably say this bit because it's probably well past, but it's Darren Lockyer. So yeah. He got given the keys to the city in 2011 as well, just by himself.
After his retirement.
Just for being Darren Lockyer. Yeah. But I'm not sure if this is definitely not allowed, but it would have been not long after he's come running through the Caxton with a headgear on and it had a half, like where his face obviously covered. So it's been made for him to play in the grand final if we had made it. So it didn't win it, but that headgear he wore. But he's, can you imagine where he landed? Where do you think he's landed?
Suncorp.
Yeah.
Suncorp. I was going to ask that.
And you're not allowed to. Nah. Yeah. Like, there's just, you can't do that.
Different time.
Like
13, 12 years ago.
Yeah. Like, I didn't look. Yeah. Very steady hand from the helicopter pilot.
The heli man, yeah. So they dropped him there and he ran.
Yeah, to here. Knowing Lockie, he wouldn't have ran. He would have got a limousine or something. Yeah. Got a Hummer. The limousine Hummer, one of those pink ones. He ran through and he was just, didn't even, like, had no care in life for his own well-being. He was running through all of us and went through into the bottle shop and then run back and then, oh, man.
Was he on one?
He was on one. Yeah, it wasn't Darren anymore. It was Daryl.
Daryl.
I don't know if anyone's heard of Daryl. But
top question I had to ask you was Daryl.
Yeah.
Explain Daryl.
Yeah. So Daryl is an alter ego for Lockie when Lockie drinks. Now, no... We lost Daryl probably back in 2011. he's been missing ever since. We haven't found him. But, man, we went on tour. Obviously, that year I made the Aussie squad to go on. We call it you get a free tour to Europe, basically.
Yeah.
Business, it's the best. Business class, 21 years old. You're just frothing. Absolutely frothing at the bit. And it's Lockie's last tour. So that was the last time I seen Daryl was in Berlin.
What at the Oppenheimer building or
club? Was in Berlin a week out of before the grand final. We got given the okay to, because we were playing Wales, we already made the final. We got given the okay to go to Berlin. And
he got the keys to Berlin.
Pretty much. Like, that was the last time I ever seen Daryl, and I'm glad because no one ever wants to see that bloke again. Because Daryl's
different.
Let me just paint this picture for you. You could imagine a kid from Roma who... They're pretty loose, you know, country kids.
Yeah.
So you could imagine what Daryl's really like if you could just plant that in your head. And we've never seen him since, but it was a pleasure to be able to witness it, that's for sure. He's great. Daryl's great to be around. Yeah, and I used to call Daryl a lot about 3 a.m. in the morning and he just got the shits with me once and just said, you know, fuck off, Daryl.
You're like, Daryl, please come back. Come out of retirement, Daryl.
Well, I used to do the Donald Duck to his kids.
Yeah.
So I used to talk like this.
What?
Yeah. I used to talk like that to his kids every time I'd ring up 3 a.m. in the morning. And it was obviously fun while it started. Yeah. But then it was just like when he retired, he just had enough. He was like, just fucking leave me alone now. So I haven't done it for a while. But, you know, might have to revisit that this Christmas.
How did it go again?
When the fuck did you realise you could do that?
Oh man, when I started playing footy, man, I got corrupted pretty, like, just party tricks became a thing.
Yeah.
You know, just to do some cool party tricks, and that was one of mine. I used to be Jamaican when I go out all the time and try and pick up Sheilas.
What was your name?
I didn't really have one. I just would be like, hey, girl. Where are you from? You know.
What are you, Chris Gale or something?
Barbados, yeah. I don't know why I used to do that, but me and a mate of mine just used to do that, so.
Did you pull, like, your Usain Bolt or some shit like that? Or?
Oh, no. No, no way. I reckon he's packing.
Oh, is he packing big time?
So it's probably not
really not comparative.
No, definitely not. I'm the wish version of Usain Bolt.
What was, if Darren was Daryl, what were you?
Oh, so my alter ego is Lomas. And that's my grandfather's grandfather's name. My grandfather's a very quiet man. So, you know, I don't know. We just started – we just used to call me Lomas. And, yeah, you don't really want to meet him.
No.
No, he's a bit full on. Still, you might have met him. You've met him a few times.
I've met him a couple of times. Yeah. He's full on and in your face.
Yeah,
tell
yeah.
You
he's he brings a lot of energy.
Really?
And he's hard to kick out of places.
God, that's a dirty match. I'd love to know what Darren says about Lomas.
Oh, well, I don't know if I really had Lomas back then.
Oh, back then, okay.
Yeah, when, when I hurt myself, I just became a different person. Like, after I got better from sort of, you know, being down and after I've, you know, finished footy, I just become this weird, weird, weird person. Become a completely
that's all
different
right.
person. Yeah, there's nothing that's wrong with right. that. Nothing wrong with that. So, yeah, Lomas is my alter ego, and he probably comes out once a year now, and that's at my birthday. I try to only bring him out once a year.
I call bullshit.
Well, you've met him. Actually, yeah, you've met him a few times already this year.
Sources like,
no, last year, yeah.
I saw Lomas last week.
Oh,
nah, Lomas is all right. Lomas is a bit of fun.
He is a bit of fun. And that's the big thing about Lomas. He just wants to have fun, so he just doesn't want to leave. Like, I just don't want to ever leave.
Yeah.
I don't want to go. I do have a thing called the ball and chain now with my wife, so it's a bit easier to go home, you know.
Yeah.
Because
when she taps you on the shoulder.
Oh, yeah.
Those nuts are getting dragged out of there real quick. Yes.
Mine's Elton Pickles.
Elton Pickles.
Yeah.
I like that.
I get a bit funky.
Is that both your nicknames? So, like, Berkey and...
His last name's Burke.
Yeah, okay. Stock standard.
Yeah. Source originated from an assembly one time. There was a joke about red nuts and rangers, and it was like, put the fire out.
Oh, okay.
And I got tackled by, I think, Frenchie and Fonty.
Oh, French Fries.
French Fry Postal. His brother Ted Post played for the Force and shit, and then Alec Fontalvo, has nothing to do with the story, but they tackled me and sprayed water over my head. Oh. I think in like year 10 and go, Sauce, put the fire out.
Oh, no.
And I hated it. I absolutely hated it.
And then I,
for the first week, I was like copping Sauce all the time. And then I was like, you know what? Fuck it.
Now it's just, you just got to go.
If you roll
with
your nickname, it's fine.
Roll with the punches.
Could have been worse.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know? My nickname's Dean.
Yeah.
I've got a mate called Dean.
After Dean Witters. Because when I stopped playing footy, I got a bit.
You get a bit chunky.
Yeah. And so it's so bad. And obviously, because Dino is obviously Aboriginal as well, and so am I. So just, it all matched up, and the boys just call me Big Dino. That's my nickname.
You can't give yourself a nickname either. No. Just,
this
you
know. Fucker does give himself
I didn't give myself
Elton
Pickles.
He gave himself the nickname King of the North.
No, I didn't. Oh, the bloody Britney Spears toys.
Might as well just have a cock on his forehead.
I did not. Oh, no, I put my foot down. Ask Darcy Clutz. They gave me that. It's lame. It's like... It's because I play for North.
I got a mate who
no
I
one
call,
plays for North.
Who I call Piggy Riddell because he's a fat fuck.
Okay, there's nothing.
So, but Piggy's a great man.
Yeah, no, I mean one of the greatest celebrations of all time. Like, probably the greatest of all time. Got fined for it.
Did
like,
he get fined for doing
yeah,
that?
Yeah, he got fined. Yeah, he got fined for it.
That's
why they've. Why do you think no one's ever delved back into that?
Yeah, fair.
They got fined. Like, there's one thing about rugby league players they hate. Getting fined and losing money.
Isn't it funny that he's remembered for that?
They'll spend it on piss. His, and pokies.
That was his thing?
That was his thing.
Now that I think of it, it's a bit Hail Hitler-ish, isn't it?
Well, the whole
I never thought of that.
Well, it's probably a good... Well, it's a good thing that we've never thought about that.
Yeah.
Well, I suppose we don't live in that world. You know, that you obviously over there, that's... You can't do that.
No, fuck, not anyway.
But I suppose if they had watched the game,
isn't that strange that that's those two things he's remembered for? That try celebration is and his kick.
Yeah,
like how he would kick.
He would have been good for Try July, Piggy Riddell.
Oh.
But he's got to find the line. That's the issue.
He could. He was all right.
He was jink and bustle like down low.
He
was like a little wombat.
He was a little wombat.
He had a bit of witters about him. Definitely a mutters.
Yeah.
Who would be good? Like, who was one of your best? Like, who would you get around? Like, when you're talking about Daryl Madman.
Yeah, like this. This is a good question.
Yeah, talk to us about that.
Because there's some absolute standouts.
We've got time.
If drink and piss was a competition and another, you know, another NRL, like, let's just put it that way. If it was a whole nother competition, oh, there's a fair few people I'm taking with me.
Give us a team.
Well, I did have a team. Shit. This is getting me excited.
Yeah,
drinking team. All right. Well, from me back in the day, the number one for for me would be Josh Hoffman.
The fullback?
Yes. Yep. Yeah, he'd be fullback. The Black Mamba, his nickname was.
That's what I call my car.
Yeah. Oh, do you? Oh, yeah, you do too. Well, we got a different reason why we call Hoffy the Black Mamba.
Tell us.
Well, he used to always pull his pants down over his cheeks and it looked like the Black Mamba.
That is so good.
It's disgusting, but he would get, you know, get pretty full and he'd do it. So it was funny. That is, can't believe I just said that. He's going to be filthy at me. Back my bar. That's what he would say when he would do it. He's one, honestly, I think people forget it, but he's one funny motherfucker, man.
Is he?
Oh, yeah. My God. Like, he just always up for a good time. Yeah. Like, just always fun. Always brings energy when we go do something as well. Like, it feels like we're sort of, you know, slowing down. And getting, and he's like, nah.
And Hoffy's like,
yeah,
nah.
he's ready to bring it up.
That's good.
So he's definitely someone who I, and you know what, I've had some of the best drinkers be at number one. Like I played with Carmichael Hunt as well.
Yeah,
but I'll say that, like, for him, yeah, he's right up there.
Yeah.
I'd have to put myself as one of the wingers.
Okay. Like, I can't. Oh, Lomas.
I don't fucking Junior Dell.
No, I can drink with myself at the best of them. I can sit there with a mirror and drink with myself. I'll be fine. Be
you and Lomas.
You'd love that. Yeah. You'd be talking to Gerard. I'd be talking to Lomas.
What are you looking at, your man?
I'm not fucking leaving.
Oh, God.
Who else you got?
My wife happy for me to do that at home, I tell you that much. Probably the other winger in prime would be Oatsy. Like, he's good value.
Brains.
To drink piss with.
Brainsy.
This is tough. I've had some good centres drink piss with, but Jack Reed would be number one for me.
The Pommy.
Oh, mate, can drink piss.
Really?
I was actually he was at my house over the weekend and I was starting to cook breakfast at 10:30 and all I hear is I look behind me, I'm like, what are you doing? He's like, I'm thirsty. I've been licking salt blocks all week. And I'm like, oh God, Jesus.
What does he do now? What does he do these days?
It's a good question. Yeah. Nah, he's in game development at the Brisbane Broncos. Does a very good job. He looks after the whole of Sunshine Coast.
How good.
Yeah. Good man.
Yeah, to be honest, that whole game dev is killing it. They got Gillo, they got Matt, what do you call it, Andrew McCulloch.
You're just naming all your mates.
Well, they're the people that are in there.
What a crew.
Yeah. Mick Hancock, Michael Devia.
Mick Devia is one of the nicest blokes you'll ever meet.
Goat.
Absolute the nicest goat. Blokes.
Absolute goat. Anyway, the other winger, oof.
Hodges?
Oh, the other centre, sorry.
Yeah.
Hodges. Hodges is good fun, but he sprays you a lot. So it's just like, do you really want him around? So it's just like, yeah, he's really good value, but if he's spraying you, you don't want him to be there.
Yeah.
But you probably put him in there. If I was going to say someone that I haven't had, it'd be Tones. He'd be in there, Katoni.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I haven't played with, it'd be Tones. Yeah. Good value on the piss.
Yeah.
Halves. Oof. Well, it's Daryl.
Daryl.
One of them. And don't leave that other fuckwit at home, Darren. leave him at home and bring Daryl. We don't want Darren. I love him so much. He's such good value.
The seven.
Yeah. Well, Dozer. It'd be Hunty.
Yeah. Easy. Yeah.
That's an easy win for him because he's outstanding. And my hooker would be Macca. Like,
yeah.
I'm sure you've seen them at their fullest.
Oh yeah,
Sterling. Here at the Caxton, and they're very good
country
value.
Bloke.
Yep.
Good so Dozer bloke. Has a genuine crack.
Oh mate, he's very good. Yeah, he loves. He's just a fun time.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's just a fun time. Just a fun country boy. He used to love the, or he still does love the black rats, the Rumbos.
Really? That's the go-to?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. We actually at his wedding, I don't know how much piss he went had, but there was just all Rockhampton people, obviously, and we went through it all at halfway. He had to go get some more. They had to go buy another 50 cases of alcohol. It's incredible. Touché, Rocky.
Who's your forward pack?
Vegas.
Yeah. That's a good spine, by the way.
Yeah
it's a great spine.
Yeah.
You should have to do this every week now.
Yeah. I'm liking this.
I know. Big boys in the middle. Man.
This is where we're really finding the work.
Well,
you'd have Gillo there.
Well, Gillo would, he'd be a back row.
He's a bit humble. He's a back row. He's humble, isn't he?
He's a back row. Yeah, he's very humble. But he would be my back row. And Bola, Sammy Thaido would be one. Yeah.
Big slammer.
Yeah. Big black nuts, he'd be right there. He'd be. I love him. Love him too.
Big pitbull.
Yeah. Oh, mate, he's good value. He can bring his budgies any day to the party.
Mate, we're getting a shout out from Budgie soon. We have to.
Yeah. Give it to him. Righto, so who's our front row? We skipped.
Yeah, the front rows are hard. Like, for disclosure reasons, I probably shouldn't pick this bloke because he's in a bit of Barney rubble at the moment, but you do want him around a crew if they're drinking piss, and that's Josh Maguire.
Big Moosey.
Yeah, yeah. The big show.
The big show. Yeah. The big show. Yeah. You know why we called him the big show?
He called himself that, didn't he?
Yeah, he did, but then I called him Showbags because he's just full of shit. The Eck has just gone too, by the way. It's a good plug for him as well.
Is he in Brizzy at the moment or no?
I don't know. Not sure.
He's in over
don't care. He's I love him, but I just might keep me distance at the moment. Big Moosey. Love him to bits. He got dropped. He got a bit of Barney rubble.
Yeah,
He's someone you want to go to war with. Like, you have to have him on your team. But
I used to love him at the Bronx.
Drinking wise, you have to have him there. So that's one of my fronties. Oh, gosh. I mean, I'll probably...
What about the polar bear? Was he
getting
No, he doesn't drink.
Oh, is he fully... Yeah.
But he's might need someone like him.
Yeah.
You know, to straighten us out.
Yeah. Off the bench, mate.
No, we're not. Sorry. we call him Big Cheesy Omelette. No, we don't want him.
Oh.
Omelette, that's his nickname.
Yeah,
Big Cheese.
Didn't Wayne give him that?
The Big Cheese, yeah. You're getting the big fella for a little bit. Went back to the Ipswich Jets and we played Benny and the Jets when he came in the sheds one day. Benny and the Jets. He was so filthy. Filthy, he was.
Hasn't he got like 7 kids?
Yeah, he lives down the coast.
Probably now he's just got 8. He's probably got 8 now. He's just over this podcast. He's probably had another one.
He'd have a nutsack on him, surely.
Well, he's obviously...
Yeah. He's just busting them out each week.
Yeah, he is. The other one, I'd probably go, because he's great value, Nick Kenny. Like,
oh, yeah.
Yeah,
Ken really?
Kenny. Yeah.
Ken drink piss.
Ken drink
piss. Tell you a story about him in Mexico before we move on. When we went on a... When we went on a thingy in Mexico, end of year trip, it was Cancun. Mm. And there's a place called Senor Frogs there. And it's got a big slide going through it. All those people that I've just mentioned, by the way, all those players, most of them were here at this trip. Anyway, it was like 10 a.m. in the morning. Of course, we were there drinking. It's an end of year trip. Anyway, we're all going down and there's pictures going. It's into the ocean, but it's all netted off.
Yeah.
And there's pictures and you get to do pictures. Anyway, we're all looking at the pictures and they're sort of slowly coming through and we're all laughing at them. We get one. There's Killer, naked. just fully legs open. Seeing his black mamba. his version of it. And that was a funny.
White mamba.
Yeah, but it gets even better. So there's a pool table on the deck. There's a massive deck over the water. And Josh Maguire thought it was a good idea to start throwing Killer's, that's Nick Kenny, Killer.
Yeah.
Killer's like thongs and stuff into the water. So Killer's filthy, jumps in. And these Mexican people start coming out, running out, freaking out. Going, no. And everyone's like what? They've pulled a boat around, like a little dinghy. And they've grabbed him in it. And then they go, no, big alligators live underneath. No lie, no word of a lie. And we're like, fuck off. That's bullshit.
He would have loved that
and
too.
And while Killer's out there, Josh is trying to spear him with pool tables. Like, it was a debacle. Anyway,
did you see any gators?
Well, we get kicked out and they go, you can come back because you've paid a lot of money, but you come back later. You need to cool off and stop drinking for a bit. Everyone's like, yeah, of course we're going to do that.
Whatever.
Go back, spotlights on two massive alligators, man. Like, huge.
Oh, wow.
Like, I'm talking 6-7 feet, like four, 6 or 7 foot long. Just swim out from under. They live underneath there.
Yeah.
So we could have lost Nick Kenny that day.
Wouldn't that be a story?
Yeah, that would've
I would have.
Bronco dies.
You boys like Mexico. I would have never come back. I would have just stayed there. That would have been the scariest.
What was the place called?
Senor Frogs.
Senor Frogs.
Who plans that trip? Is there someone that runs the tour? Like, out of the boys puts their hand up?
No, yeah. I think Peter Wallace organised it, actually. But we...
Yeah.
But the club organised security and everything, so...
That's sick.
Yeah, to go with
it. Bit of a Red Frog crew.
Oh, yeah. So you have security and everything
yeah,
there.
Yeah, yes, correct, yep.
Because that fucking starting lineup with no security would just be absolute
Well, we'll get to our security. but our two fronties are that. Back rows will be Jillo and Sammy. Me lock, oh, gosh.
This is important.
This is a very important role, the lock position.
Cozza?
Nah.
Oh.
Nah.
Nah, probably not. The bird doesn't make it on this tour. No.
He would have been eaten by the gator.
Yeah. Hopefully.
Have I just brought up something touchy there?
No, he's great. He's good. He's good, but he just wouldn't make my drinking team.
Yeah.
He wouldn't make my drinking team.
Shit off.
Jeez, you could hear crickets then, couldn't you? You could hear a pin drop. You could value birdies. Just not on the piss.
Yeah, yeah, not this.
I wouldn't take him with me.
So is
our lock. Yeah, I don't know. That'd be tough because we've been a lot of different locks over the time. But I'd probably, if it's now, this day and age, I'd probably take Paddy Carrigan.
Yeah.
I've gone a bit too rogue there with Jones and Paddy, but
who would you go back in your day?
You need a bit of fresh blood.
Yeah, I love me some fresh blood.
He's a good man, eh?
And he'd get some, those two especially, they'd get some chicks around.
Oh, there'd be some talent.
Yeah,
well.
When you were single, obviously.
Oh, yeah, obviously. Yeah, one dog, one bone. What's that? bench, four off the bench, just. Well, I'd have to. Oh no! My lock would be Alex Glenn, definitely.
Oh, yeah, true. Yeah,
Lexi,
God.
What am I on
Lexi.
About? Jeez,
well, Paddy
fuck,
on the
you
bench.
Need to apologise there to Lexi. Yeah. That's bad.
Nah, not saying sorry to him. Sexy Lexi, the dreamboat. That's what they called him. Everyone called him that. They would all jump aboard back in the day.
He'd have a field day back in the day.
Oh, he was just he was just a nice guy.
Yeah,
and he just looked good. Sword.
So handsome.
I'll tell you, one of your bench players, Normie.
Yeah, well, I was tiptoeing around that.
Yeah.
Because what comes with Corey Norman comes with dramas. And, I mean, it's probably the right thing. We're on, you know, off-field drama.
Yeah.
So we probably have to add him in there.
Throw him in. Well, I was going to say, would you have Carmichael at 14?
Nah, I'd definitely have Normie.
Normie.
Yeah, yeah. Not saying I wouldn't want Kay. I'd definitely have Normie. Because he'd bring a lot of energy.
Yeah.
Is he just a wild cat?
Yeah, he's a fun guy to be around.
Yeah.
He's out of I call it Eagleby. I call it Illegalby. That's where he's from. You know, him and his mum Sandy. You know, she's a single mother and she did a pretty good job. I mean, for getting this far. So
where did he grow up? Is he
Illegalby?
Eagleby.
Yeah. See those headphones on around, Berkey?
I'm still rattled by the cosser.
Yeah. Don't be rattled by that. Don't be rattled by that.
Righto, so then who's our other player?
Yeah, man. This is, like, he's got put me on the spot for this, but there's...
Yeah, that's all right.
Yeah, I mean, I'd probably have to put Kay in there. Kay was very good at what did.
You got one more, so you got Paddy.
No, so you got two more bench players.
No, whatever.
Yeah, give us two more bench players.
Two more benchies, yeah.
Oof. Coach would be Alfie / Waterboy.
I think Alf would make me team.
Yeah, good.
Yeah, he's
good.
My bees. Yeah. I mean, he can't be in the starting, unfortunately.
Yeah.
Because that's like picking a, you know, when you're on FIFA and you're picking like,
it'd be unfair.
Like Neymar.
It'd
or,
be unfair,
know,
yeah.
Lionel Messi.
It wouldn't be right to take, you know, Alf starting.
No. So, he could just be my Bobby Boucher.
Yeah, he could be.
Waterboy, yeah.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah.
You wouldn't need to ask him either. He'd probably be there already.
I'd actually, you know what? And Hook would be my coach because he can drink piss as well. And he's really
Rocky
like,
boy.
You're fucking mad, boy. Oh, don't bloody do that. That's how he talks. That's what he would say. Oh, it would be a real problem having...
You sounded like Morgan Freeman just then.
No. He's
white. So Hook had a crack.
Oh, mate. It was the best. He still is the best.
Yeah. Really?
He's so much fun. He is. He's so much fun. I'd probably have Brendan. I don't know. You guys would know. Brendan Gibb. He used to play for North South, but he was in my under 20 side.
Yeah. Right.
And he could play footy.
Good fella.
Great fella and could drink piss. Now he's he just doesn't drink piss anymore. He's given it up because that's how good he was at it.
He drank enough.
Oh, he drank enough.
He realised I can't get any better at this. So.
Yeah, yeah.
I'll hang up the boots. Hang up the bottles.
Oh, man. Like, it's a real...
Last but not least.
Yeah, I think I've chosen most. Like,
yeah.
Yeah, I think... You
that's
know
a
what?
Good sign.
Yeah. You know what? We're that good, we'll run with 16
men.
Yeah.
That is
we'll run the field with 16.
And Alf can pop in if he needs.
Yeah, if he needs. Oh, I tell you what, he wouldn't be bringing water in those bottles.
Some Fireball.
Oh, it'll be
Black Zambuca.
It'll be Zambuca.
How did? Because Wayne doesn't drink either, right?
No, he's a non-drinker.
No, but he is fun.
Yeah,
like he does bring fun, Wayne. But I didn't get coached by Wayne.
No,
like I was here when he was at the club, but I didn't get coached.
You'd have anything to do with him?
No, unfortunately not.
Fuck me.
He's
genius. That's a cracking side.
It's a good side. It's a good side. Get a bit excited, boys.
Yeah, that cheered me up a bit.
Yeah. I might have to get the 20s crew back together.
Oh.
Yeah. Just for a We use upstairs, is that right?
Absolutely.
You could do a little anniversary.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, what did we, it was 2008 when we, yeah, that was the inaugural year.
Of 20s.
Yeah, and we still haven't caught up since.
Speaking of that, that was that famous game against Canberra.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Funny, we talk about Canberra because we've got Canberra this weekend.
Yeah. Do we? Saturday night.
GIO Stadium down there in Canberra.
Yeah.
I just took them at the line too, 7.5. Got on early.
I don't.
You're a Bronx fan. You take the Raiders.
No, minus 7.5 Bronx.
Got him a beauty.
I don't see the Bronx losing a game for the rest of the year.
We've got Storm last round.
I don't think they're going to lose that.
It's Old Boys Day too.
It's up here.
It's Old Boys Day at Suncorp as well.
Thursday night.
Yeah, for the Bronx.
I believe.
I've gone to the last probably 6 or 7 games against Storm, but and it's normally a 40-point drumming.
Yeah, it'll be a warm-up audition because it looks like we're probably going to play them.
No, we'll play Warriors.
It depends.
I'd rather play the Wires
in finals.
Yeah.
So would I.
I wouldn't like to play the Storm back-to-back.
But the thing is, we've got to play the Wires here. They have the biggest following of New Zealand people here in Brisbane. So it would be so loud for them as well. Like, I'd rather play the Storm.
Really?
Really?
Yeah, because they're the benchmark. They know where you are. So you get them at home and you get a chance.
What would that be like playing them 2 weeks in a row? You'd figure each other out a lot.
Well, yeah. I mean, Craig Bellamy's very smart what he does. I actually don't think he would play a full-strength side if they know they're going to be in that position. He would rest a lot of his players.
I was going to say, they did that.
You reckon they would?
I reckon he would.
Yeah.
They've done that in the AFL where they'll rest players because you're kind of giving it away a bit.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So you can just hold your cards back.
Yep. Yep.
Yeah, that's an interesting one if we played them back-to-back.
Yeah, and to be honest, you wouldn't want to do that to the fans, but in saying, like here at Suncorp, to not picture. Play your players, like play your better players. But I think Kevy would do the same thing because you got to understand.
Nah.
You don't reckon?
I don't reckon they would.
Well, so if we sewed up second position.
Yeah.
I just don't reckon you would do that, like for the confidence of the team.
No, it's not. I don't think it's just more the confidence of the team. I think it's more of it's going to be a brutal game. It's a brutal game. Oh. It's like going five weeks in a row of finals.
Mm.
You're going to play them and then, I mean, you'd obviously want to win and get the week off, but then those players, the majority Origin players, they get a chance to have that rest because they've played big minutes during the year.
Yeah, so say the Bronx rest a couple of their players.
Well, Adam Reynolds isn't playing this week either.
We probably need to rest Reynolds.
Because of
his baby cows.
Yeah.
You know, we need them to get right.
Fuck, bro. Yeah. Calves are just the hot topic in Australian sport.
I mean, I've heard, you know, you boys have been talking about it a lot.
Oh. We've been talking about calves a lot.
Calves are the backbone of
your body.
We don't feel drama.
Yeah, I know. And we don't need to talk about mine because I don't have any, so it's fine.
you and me both.
It's a little bit like Daryl back in 2011. They've gone missing.
I love seeing Daryl running around with his lid off. Rosalie, every day.
He needs to eat something. I'm just a bit worried about him.
Hey, just a chiseled Daryl.
He needs to eat something.
Is he fit?
Yeah, he's so fit.
Fuck yeah, he's fit.
He's hot.
He always was.
He's got a bit of like hamburger meat, you know, obviously a bit of hair, like hanging in some.
He's got such a nice pad too, eh? Rosalie there?
Yeah,
gorgeous little.
Does everyone know where he lives? We just give him that away.
It's known that he lives in Rosalie.
Yeah, I know where he lives.
Yeah. Don't give the shareholders his address. I tried to break in
there a few times. So.
Have you really?
But I have drunk a lot of his Grange before.
Oh, right.
Really? Yeah,
not knowing how expensive it is. I was just thinking, oh, this is awesome. I'm just drinking red wine with Darren Lockyer. And he was just letting us.
Are you clicking the bell, doing your little fucking duck, goose voice or whatever it is?
Oh, I'd never turn up at his house. That would be weird if I just randomly turned up at his house.
These days it would be, for sure.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I still talk to him like every now and then. Yeah. I just call him out of the blue and just ask him how he's going.
Yeah, nice.
And he just, you know. He probably doesn't care for me too much for all those times I've called him. But
fuck off, Gerard.
But Laura, it's him again. He's calling me.
The strangest thing that I always get asked is the place across the road, which is now Honeybees.
Yeah.
He used to own
the little store.
He used to own the bar there, called Mirasol or maybe something before that. I get asked that like weekly. They're like, does Darren Lockyer still own a bar on this street? I'm like, no, I don't know if he owns the building. He might own the building, but he used to own that bar. Did you ever go there?
I think I did. I think I did a big poo there, actually.
What?
Oh, well, I need to go to the toilet.
We obviously did, if you remember that. It must have been a big shit.
Yeah, it was a memorable one.
Yeah.
Laid some big gable in there. Yeah. Went to work, actually.
You laid down a big black mamba.
Yeah.
Where is Joshy Hoffman these days?
Oh, he's still around. Don't worry.
Is he on the Goldie?
He's like the black. Just watch out. Nah, he lives around near me. He lives in the Hills District. He was in Townsville for a while with obviously he played for the Hawks.
After
he left Parramatta, but he's actually playing at West Panthers.
Is he in Barton?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Well, they're based Mitchie. Out of Mitchie. They're based out of Mitchie. But he played on the weekend. Some poor guy just got jammed by him. Some poor soul.
Fed by the
just
mamba.
Got black mumbered.
Yeah. Black mumbered. Did he moon him as well?
He stood over the top of him. Really showed his dominance. Black mamba.
What position is he one?
No, he's playing in the halves.
Oh, sick.
Yeah, he's still, he's rolling the shoulders over. I don't think his legs can, like us all, like your legs get a bit old and you don't want to run as much. And at fullback, you got to do a fair bit.
Did you ever fancy yourself as a fullback, ever?
When I was younger, but to be honest, the game was evolving too fast of passing the ball. Didn't really want to. I just wanted to run.
What was Bishop Park like? Bash up.
Bash up.
That's one of my favourite places to play.
My dad used to play there.
Really?
Steve, yeah. He was in North Sport. Back in the 70s.
No, actually, I've had that conversation with him, actually. Yeah.
With Kevin?
Yep.
Great leaguesy now as well.
They've really done it up. But you know what? I'm a bit of a purist. I like how the old stuff was too. Yeah, you know, okay. I'm glad they haven't changed the pig pen too much. Like it still stays the same. And I've got so many good memories there at North. So I played over, I think it would have been like over 150 from 150 games from when I was 12 years old there. So
really?
Yeah. Since two of my senior days.
Shit.
Yeah. So, I played a lot of footy.
Yeah.
Yeah. A lot of footy there when I was, and back then they had, obviously they had those cups, like you could play President's Cup when you were younger. So there was more comps going on insider. Like they just don't do that. I don't think they do President's Cup anymore.
It's like
a knockout comp in the middle of your season when you're younger.
It used to be called wasn't that like the AMCO Cup? Back
I think
in the day
so. It was called that. But yeah, it was a really fun place to be. And Melbourne Storm were really, they were their feeder club at the time when I was coming through. So, I had a front row seat at the fresh, Greg Inglis. So, before he played for Melbourne,
God, he was, man,
he was running amok. And it was just like, I think that's when I knew and a lot of the players knew that's when they wanted to play for. Like, that's when I knew I wanted to play rugby league.
Yeah.
When I watched GI, I was like,
he used to have the blonde.
A bit like breezy, crisp. He looked like Chris Brown. Get it up, yeah. He's just different. He was just a different footy player, And I think that's why a lot of us younger boys at that stage, he's not that much older than us, but he was already playing against men.
So,
and obviously the hype around Melbourne at the time and how good they were going and sort of wanted to be in their system, but. They weren't looking for bumps like me.
Munster? No, he was East.
No, he was East. And that's when they were with Melbourne.
Yeah.
Fuck, so shit. What GI, do you ever get on the piss with him?
Oh, yeah.
Because he could have easily Goanna. Made that team, yeah. surely.
Yeah, well, there's a lot of, I could have put a lot of Origin players in Australia, but I feel like I've got to stay true. Yeah, I've got to be loyal to the soil, You've got to make sure I put those boys in there. And week in and week out, I'm drinking piss with those boys. So I know their tendencies. I know who they are.
What did you call him? Sorry, Goanna?
The Goanna.
Yeah.
Talk us through that.
He does the Goanna.
Oh, that one. Yeah. No, I thought there was
it. Does he even watch footy? Like, do you watch footy? Or
I thought it was like his cock called the Goanna or something.
He's all right. He's still learning.
I watch rugby league in my sleepy.
I'm not sure that's possible, but
you might dream.
But if it is.
Mate, you'd be surprised. I'm listening to press conferences and all sorts of shit.
I love listening to the press conferences these days.
Mate, so good.
Seabold? Did anyone see? Yeah, Seabs. Jeez.
Fuck, did an ET or?
Why don't we just touch on that subject?
Yeah, let's go.
Let's delve into that. Penalty every day of the week.
Yeah, it was.
It's a penalty every day of the week.
That's ridiculous.
You know what? There was a lot of I was seeing a lot of Tuves coming out of that press conference from. He was channeling a lot of Jeff Tuvey out of that press conference. Manly, I thought he was going to say that. I thought he was going to say there's got to be an investigation. If he had said that, there's got to be an investigation.
That would have been one of the all-time.
Oh, my gosh. Put me out of my misery. Like, I've lived life. Do you know what I mean? If he had said there needs to be, I thought there was a couple of times on the tip of his tongue where I thought he was going to go, there needs to be an investigation. But he's just said it in a more Harvard, how he would smart
he,
way.
Didn't he go to Harvard?
He did. That's why I said that.
This could be so just left field. Isn't he just a wanker?
Oh, he's not. No, he's not. No,
or just
not.
A fraud?
No, I look.
A fraud?
I think.
Jesus Christ.
That's Lobo.
I've just heard things that like.
I don't think.
His philosophy on coaching and like how.
I think he's trying to change the game. That's what I think he's trying to do.
Fucking start by winning a game.
Yeah.
You know.
Can't argue with that.
The foursome backs thing was hilarious. You know.
Yeah, the boys just let the boys play. You know?
Like, would have been good if Dylan Edwards kicked it back.
I'm not sure, and I'm pretty close with Chez, but I don't really talk to footy about, like, I don't really talk footy when I talk to my footy mates. Yeah. I just talk about life, but it'd be really interesting to ask sort of, you know, what was the thought process? Because for me, if we're going to talk about that, I don't think that Manly can't not get in an arm wrestle. I think they're a good enough team. I think any footy player would hate to hear, I don't think we could get an arm wrestle as a coach. I think he stuffed up there. I didn't think we as a team could get an arm wrestle.
Sick. Thanks for backing us.
Yeah, I think you need to, he probably wouldn't change his words because I think he's very stern with what he would say, but I'd be filthy if that was me as a team. Like, I'd be like, well, yeah, we can. We can. We've got that. We've got the dog in us. You got to let us.
Yeah.
Do you remember when Storm played Manly earlier in the year? It was probably game of the...
And they beat him.
And that was so physical. That, like, Manly's just gone completely away from that, I feel. Like, that was...
Yeah. They got a lot of players out, though.
Yeah.
You know, they're signing Matt Lodge and fucking Aaron Woods.
Yeah.
They're struggling with front rowers.
I'd love Woodsy to hang up the boots, personally.
Mm-hmm.
You reckon he's done? Start doing Triple M.
He's pretty good at Triple M. Yeah. I'm not lying to you.
I like his analysis.
Yeah, analysis. That's the word.
That's what we said the other day. We were talking about this the other day, and I said Jarrell's actually a really good analyst, and then he goes an analyst, and I was like, you just did what I did.
Sometimes it's hard to say words.
Yeah.
Okay, because English is a really
an
hard
analyst.
English is the hardest language in the world. Yeah.
Fucking hell, mate.
We've been doing it our whole life and we're still fucking up.
Hey, I can't pronounce half the Kiwis or Solis in this.
Stefan, I probably get this wrong.
Uto Ikamanu. No, that's correct.
Yeah. How do you say it, Samuel?
No, I can't.
I've heard him butcher it, so we just let him. Let's to all the respect to all the islanders out there. We might just because they might be waiting at the front.
We mean no disrespect at all.
I need those security guards that you were going to mention about that you had in Mexico.
Oh, mate. Sometimes I need them, like in everyday life. Some of the shit I do, I'm like, fuck, I shouldn't have done that. Probably shouldn't have done that, but anyway.
How was Origin camps?
Yeah, Origin camps were fun. I mean, anyone you talk to, I mean, I know you've had Alf on, but I've got exactly the same, you know, feelings and, you know, morals about how I see Origin camp, and it's about a family. Like, it's so much fun. Oh. You go in there, you honestly cross it off on your calendar, you know. I was lucky that I got four Origin camps in me because the three I played and I was 18th man for one of them.
Yeah.
So the 18th man one was the best ever.
Yeah.
Because I didn't have to play. So I just drank piss. I just drank piss and wasn't really supposed to because I've got to go back and play for the Bronx. But
you're not going to drink piss.
No, hell no.
No.
Like that's – and especially if Alf's got you, right, like – It's hard to when you're on his hip, he's throwing short balls. You're going to run the line, you know. Like you're going to run the line. You're going to go through. So he was a big advocate.
He's not throwing hospital balls.
Fuck. No,
he's
they're straight to the chest.
Oh, definitely. Or he's going through himself, and you're following, and you're following there to celebrate with him. That's what they're doing. He's
with
good
a tequila value. Shot or something. Oh,
Zambuca. I love Zambuca now because of him.
And Fireball.
Yeah. So I. We would just, all of us boys would start with that. Like, that's what he would start us on. Now I'm just so immune to it. Like, yeah. I would rather do a Zambuca shot than a tequila shot any day of the week.
Really?
And I'll do 1,000 of them if I have to.
I'd go Zambuca over Fireball too. I don't know if I can do
it. Tequila.
I'm pretty, like, if you get me in a mood and Lomas comes out, you could just give me anything.
I reckon you'd twist it if you go, if your first thing is a vodka shot.
Yeah.
I reckon that's just
like a lot of us.
Cracked out.
A lot of us would fold like origami.
Mate, when I went to
with
Russia.
With a shot.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
I went to Russia for the Soccer World Cup, and our tradition was when we went out for lunch and dinner, you have to vodka. Start with vodka. And yeah. It was
vodka
so nice.
Their vodka is legit.
Yeah. Oh, hi, it was
they
gorgeous.
Don't even drink chasers.
No, yeah. It's fucked. Mad it was bastards. Delicious.
Oh, anyway, we'd not give them
so where did you
time.
What would you start? What would you start? Alfie told us what it was like back in his day. So well, first 3 days?
Yeah, I think I was still in the era where we were probably just a little bit more lucky. Like, I was still lucky that we would get into camp, we'd do media day, and then the first night would be...
just on.
Yeah. Not be a massive one, but then you'd have beers, and then the next night you'd do a lot of promo stuff next day, and that would be the day.
Mm. Oh.
That would be the big day. So usually you get into camp Monday, you have a little bit of a beer on the Monday night, and then Tuesday promos, and then Tuesday night would be the big night.
Yeah.
Yeah, and...
And he runs the show out?
Yeah.
Does he run? Like, does he...
Well, we get... Yeah, there's obviously a manager who tells us we're going to go somewhere. Well, and then when we get somewhere, it's like he'll stand up on the bus and
yeah.
get off.
Yeah.
And then he'll lay down the law and say...
He's literally like a fucking conductor.
Yeah, yeah, he is.
He's a conductor.
He goes, listen here, fucking... You know, like he'll say, this is what we're doing. And when we get in there, if we're playing bottles, we're playing bottles. And you can't get out of it. And it's like, all right, well, we're not trying to, but that's... You know, and a lot of when I came through, me and Dane Nielsen, we both debuted as well. So when you debut, it's a big night. Yeah. It's a big one. Like, it's a big night. So, that was fun. I still remember it was at, where's in South Bank at the top rooftop bar?
Oh,
South
Bank,
Ridges?
No,
Soleil?
No, what's the one they used to do on a Sunday night?
Yes, correct, Berkey.
You know, the Sunday night.
Oh, Fox.
The Fox. Oh, jeez. Yeah.
Is that where you started?
Take me to the Fox and bury me there.
Yeah.
Like, it was the best. It was the best. You could never get up. There was only way up was stairs and the security at the bottom or the elevator. If you're a VIP, elevator straight up.
Yeah.
And you'd just open up and be like, it was the best. But we went there. That was my first origin when we went there, and they locked off everywhere, and just it was so much fun.
Yeah.
That so much so fun.
Funny story about the Fox. I was lucky because our same security guard would work there on a Sunday, and he was our main guard back in the day. And there'd be the line that he'd go massive, like around the corner. And remember, they'd have that stupid text message thing. And people would go.
You didn't need the text.
So they had this text message shit.
We're ready for you.
And they'd go, when you get the text, come back. And these poor motherfuckers would get the text like the next day, like come back. It was so whack.
That's
but
the best.
I'd be lucky where I'd see the guard and be like, how many you got? And just go, you'd go up in the elevator. You'd go with the glasses.
There's nothing better. Yeah, that's right. The glasses would be. There's nothing better when you turn up to a place, and when we had played Origin, it's just like you're a rock star.
Yeah, you're royalty.
Like, you just like after I played Origin, it was such a fun period of my life. I was only 21, like, and you just anywhere you went, you just got looked after.
Yeah,
and as long as you weren't a dickhead, you know that you still get let into places, and it would be fine. So, I think I made a real big point, and this is probably. You know, if any of these younger fellas listen, this you got to make sure. I always made friends with them, owners, managers, just because I would go out of my way to do that on purpose because I felt like it was a respect thing. You know, they were looking after me. I should do the same thing for them. And if they ever needed anything, I would be the first person. I would put my hand up and say, yeah, that's fine. And I think these days it's a bit like not all of them, a bit more entitled, you know. So and I'm not saying that's all of them. There's probably only a small margin, but they're the more margins that ruin it for people. You got to be careful with that. I mean, you're here all the time.
Well, I got to say, probably 2 years ago, we had Halloween night.
Yeah.
And Katoni was here in Payne Haas, and he was with his little group of mates and – like, they were buying drinks and stuff.
Yeah,
like
didn't
know drums. And then I realized, like, it was busy and I realized they were here.
And
then they were getting a tray of
vodka
OJs they were drinking or something. And then they're down the end of the bar and I was like, to whoever was serving, I was like, fuck, that's Payne Haas and stuff. Hadn't seen him. They must have been here for a while. And I was like, shout him the tray, whatever. And then they saw it and they're like, oh, thank you. Like, we're fucking grateful as for it. And they go into the middle of the dance where there was a table and they're just standing there having the best time, like legit just in their own little bubble before probably people would have known them for sure.
Yeah, 100%.
But before they got just really starting. Big and were just chilling and dancing and like, and I was, and like they came up and like, oh, thanks for that. You didn't need to do that. And I was like, yeah, they're good blokes.
It's
like,
and they are the good blokes. Yeah. Like, it's not, it's,
and they have a good time.
Yeah.
And not without going overboard too.
Yeah. I'd say the ones that are down south, They're a bit harder. Like they're a bit like because they're
the ones that don't get it.
Yeah, they don't get.
You know who should be converted? Who should be converted to a Queenslander if there was ever to be?
Yeah,
Payne.
Yeah,
Payne.
Yeah.
Like Jake Trbojevic, I could bring across.
Oh, yeah. We don't want Jake. He can stay. Geez. He's a manly boy through and through.
I know what you mean, though. You know, I understand. Yeah. I understand what you're saying. It's unfair. Even tones could be.
Yeah,
yeah,
right.
Tones. Yeah. Good. Yeah.
It's unfair. Sure. That
the two boys
to...
you just said. I mean, I still take the piss out of Reno every now and then. Yeah. I say, I said, you're one of us now, bro. Yeah. Like, and he hates it.
Yeah, he would hate that.
I say, like when we won this year, I say, why aren't you putting any posts up? They're not celebrating. You know, like a texting. I say, this is, you're one of us now. And then, you know what? It was so funny. I'd go back and forth with him, message him on the gram. And then there's literally the day after we'd won, I saw him at the, because he lives over near my area.
Yeah.
And I saw him at the old, the local fruit shop and he was sitting there with his missus. So I went down my window and I scared the shit out of him. I was like, you're one of us now, mate. And he didn't know for a second who it was. And he's like, fuck off, mate.
He's got a nice big pad over there, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does.
Yeah, he sorted himself right out.
Yeah.
What's he doing in houses?
Oh, it's because
I don't want to know. I don't want you to know where I fucking live, actually. Just, Dad, there's someone standing at the front.
He's just out the front beating his mamba at your house.
Oh, my God. Mate, is that what you're doing in front of people? Come on in, mate.
My boys. I fucking love them.
Hey, yeah.
Nice. We're going to have to go for a hit soon, though, because I've just bought a house on a golf course. So
yeah.
We'll have to go for a hit soon.
Yeah, Capera's your local.
Yeah, he's my local. No, everyone knows. It's okay, mate. It's okay. Just please don't tell them where it is, but it's... It's along those probably 200 houses that are on the golf course.
I know Payne lives in Ashgrove
too. Get fucked.
This is ridiculous.
It's like a Hollywood map of stars or some shit you just got going on.
Jump on Berkey's Hollywood Stars.
The stars
Berkey's
of Brisbane.
Broncos tour. There's some money in this. Just to anyone that comes here, we could just tell you know where they live. This is where Payne lives.
Fucking cry.
Actually, one good story about Payne is that my mate Saucy, he gave him free drinks on his
I would have loved one of my great things would love to be just a part of Origin team.
Yeah.
Which would be perfect, like being 18th man. But obviously, the talent's gone there. No, I was a halfback back in the day, Jharal.
He was all right. Yeah. He was actually all right. A union player.
I'll show you the clip.
He beat Nudgee in the first 15. Yeah. It was literally a final at Nudgee, and they fucking beat us.
Wow.
Halfback.
They're still talking about it.
Well, obviously.
Yeah. It resonates with us Nudgee blokes. So you only won one in the last 100 years, so it's a big deal for you guys.
Do you know any union players' houses where they live? That could be something.
They're not
home at the moment, so you could go stand at the front and do what you have to do in their houses.
Hey, the way the Reds are travelling these days, I don't know if they'd have a home.
They got townhouses.
Are the Reds still a thing?
I've got some mates playing for the Reds, so I better go easy. Yeah. Mate, you didn't play union?
I didn't know they were still here. I thought they'd packed it up and moved.
You know, there's
Perth.
A World Cup in a month or two.
Well, there's Matilda's just played in it. Yeah,
yeah.
They're living in hostels up the road. There.
Nah, well, who are the boys that come here? Oh, I was taking the piss out.
Harry Wilson.
Ryan
Smith.
What are they called?
Lawson.
What's their thingy called? I was talking about
the Queensland Reds.
Brothers.
No, the bloody potty. What are those boys called?
Pillar to Post? Pig Athletic Club.
Yeah.
Pig Athletic Club.
They're good
fellas.
They're good value.
Good blokes.
They're good value. Really running them down to the lowest on that night we were here at the Caco.
Yeah.
And they just copped it. It was good.
Good.
Actually, that's a good quickly lead up, Chris. I got a mate who's facing judiciary this week. He plays for the Gallopers, Jeebs, right? He's got a Reggie's final this week at Ballymore.
Oh, hold on. Is this? Oh, no.
Like, that's, this is like, you like, know, Jeeps, Brothers, yeah, the like... Yeah,
Queensland rugby.
Queensland, you got no
small,
idea.
Small Jeb, circle.
My mate Benji, he used to be the trainer for Brothers, so I think it is. They're in the grand final, aren't they?
Yeah. Fuck Brothers.
Bro. Oh, really? Oh, shit. Okay. Yeah. Sorry. I said their name.
Anyway, it's because I'm a Jeeps boy. Anyway, he's got a 4-match suspension this week. I don't know what it was for. I think he might have abused a ref. Was
probably rattling off Broncos players' addresses.
He's trying to get
grade three carry on.
He's trying to get it downgraded from four games to zero, which to play in the GF. That's fucking ludicrous, isn't it?
That's on the 29th. I know that is correct.
Yeah. This weekend.
It's this Sunday.
Is it this weekend?
Yeah, yeah, this Sunday.
Oh, hold on, it's the 21st. Is it going to be the 29th?
I'll see you at Ballymore, mate.
Oh, hold on. Is it?
28th.
It's this Sunday. Weekend. Yeah, this Sunday.
Yeah, I've been asked to go.
Well, it sounds like you're fucking pumped.
Oh, I don't know. I am. I'm excited.
Do you know where Ballymore is?
Yeah, it's near the Reds training facility, isn't
it? That's it.
That is the Reds training facility.
Oh, it is the Reds training facility. Oh, Jesus, they are going well. They play at Suncorp, though, Reds still, don't they?
Oh, yeah.
I'm just asking. Yeah.
Actually, shout out to that. They fucking finally figured out that taking games to Townsville and Cairns and wherever didn't work, and now they brought all the games back.
I could have bloody told you that.
Yeah.
Do you reckon he's any chance of getting off from a four game suspension to
no
zero?
No chance. Yeah, zero.
Thank you.
Like, as a, he actually might get eight.
Yeah, it's double
in the down. In the process, and he'll miss all eight next year. He'll miss seven next year. Is he retiring?
Oh, he was playing.
Who is it?
Trelly.
Oh, what are you
talking about? Trelevin. He wanted this. He's
Trelevin?
Yeah.
Has he got a dad?
Yeah, Wayne.
Trelevin. Yeah. I know Wayne. Yeah.
So his son's a wanker. No, he's a good man.
Wayne's one of the best blokes.
He is. Great man.
And Mitch.
Anyway, he's trying. He reckons he can get off to four games. He's fucking kidding himself.
What did he do? I want to know what he did. Did he shot someone or what?
No, I think he gave the touchy an absolute if, which is right up his alley.
And in rugby union, that's very against that.
It's a no-no.
It's because they're all French referees, and mate, it's all fuck. What about the...
Well, the French are pretty polite people, so they, I mean, if they're getting sworn at, they're probably like...
There would have been a bit more to it.
Yeah, exactly.
And knowing Wayne Trelevin, he's got the same vocab as Wayne.
Sorry, and also to all our French listeners, I don't actually know if you're good people, so I'm just sort of it's an allegation. Yeah, you could be bad people. I'm not sure.
I don't know what.
I don't know if you have French listeners, but oui, je m'appelle Jean.
We got plenty.
Yeah, I think we've got a bit.
We got a couple actually.
Okay.
Yeah, we cover the globe.
Yeah, you can see where your downloads are.
Oh, okay.
We've actually got.
Well, my wife's from French Canadian, so
yeah.
Really?
Yeah, she swears at me in French all the time. I don't know what's going on.
Oh, you have no idea.
Yeah.
What do we think about TPG getting tapped on the shoulder there? You think he got tapped on the shoulder?
TPJ?
TPJ. What do I call him?
TPG.
That's the internet.
I don't know. This has been a giggle, hasn't it, boys?
Yeah. Oh, fucking duck over here.
I know.
Do you reckon he got tapped on the shoulder? Like, you wouldn't leave for $700,000 a year, surely?
Look, I don't think you can just get tapped on the shoulder. Like, it's his money. I think he'd have to have gone, this is my decision.
And he wants to box.
Did that come out?
No, there's talk. I think that they're going to pay him $250,000 next year as well.
The bloke I'd be tapping is Luke Thompson. He's on 800,000 or 900,000.
I think delving into that side, there's a lot of Wes Nguyama's in that side at the moment.
Fucking Wes Nguyama.
There's so many Wes Nguyama's, and I think Uncle Gus has got a big problem on his hand.
Yeah.
And Seraldo, the poor fella, I mean, not poor fella, but he's probably filthy rich.
He's so cash.
He's, you know, you got to take this and with.
He's got a great house in Belmore, too.
Oh gosh, this is gold. I think he's coming. He was the defensive coach for Penrith.
Yeah, he was.
Yeah.
They're no defense.
But I will say this: they've had a lot of injuries this year. To stick up for him for a little bit, but they should have been a lot better.
Yeah.
So anyway, we'll see where they are. TBJ. I'm not sure. I mean, I think he would have had to have a conversation with the Rose brothers in Noma Liberty Boxing that he's going to be given a chance and a certain amount of money.
I can see
you can't walk away. But he might just have found himself. Mm. Because I've never seen him box.
He had one fight
and knocked someone out.
Yeah.
I hope so.
I think he fought at Spud Carroll.
My wife's a speechy if you need any help. She's a speech pathologist.
My call is he's going to go to the Dolphins because he's moving back to Queensland.
Yeah, well, Uncle Wayne did come out and said that he would be keen to have him. For a discounted price.
How good did he play for Penrith when he played leading up to the final?
Oh, well, I mean...
He played simple. He played literally just up the middle.
You know why? Because they had quick play of the balls. Yeah. He didn't have to do much.
You've got a good coach that's going...
Bulldogs don't have quick play of the balls.
Yeah.
No, fuck
but all
no.
he did was just run hard, straight up the guts, And that, and yeah, and he was providing quick.
I don't know. I don't know what's going to happen. But I, look, I'm not a get like. If he doesn't feel like he's up for it anymore, I think it's a big call for him to, you know, move on. Mm. Like it's, and it shows that he's matured a lot. I think because otherwise he's just gonna that place. I actually got a little bit nervous because at the same time we hadn't resigned Payne yet.
Yeah,
and then that had opened money for them. And I was a bit frantic. Yeah.
He'd never go to the Dogs.
I just called a few people that I knew and I was like, please tell me this is not happening. And they're like, no, it's going to be okay.
Because Sonny Bill was in his ear, eh?
Mm. Yeah.
That was scaring me, eh? And then the Western Force throwing their fucking...
Oh, get out.
I don't think the Western Force were in. I think
that was bullshit.
Yeah. That's a plant the seed to give Payne of trying to get
more money. Yeah.
I think that was the whole background of it is his agent was... saying, oh, we're going to approach the open market.
He's doing his job. He's doing his job.
He wants more money for himself. Yeah. And he's going, look, there's a chance he might leave and add a bit of media hype. And then, they've signed him.
Well, the thing about it now is we've got him for 4 years.
And I love what he's come out and said. He said, I've been here with Katoni and Patty for since they were in 20s or younger.
17, yeah.
Yeah, whatever. And they were like, and he was like, I don't want to just win one.
We've got unfinished. He's got unfinished business.
I want to win a couple. Yeah.
It'd be nice if they won it this year, went back to back and went thrice.
That would be so loose.
Yeah, for all the Broncos fans out there, buckle yourselves up because it's going to be a beautiful, nice, smooth couple of years. I'm not saying we're winning it, but I'm saying it ain't going to be like the last couple of years where we're in for a good treat.
Fuck, dude. It just feels right this year, eh? It does.
I mean, sometimes things align and they've just got to – they need to win week one. You just can't go and win it from – it's really hard to. You've got to win week one in the finals and have a week off because it's too hard to do because the finals are brutal. And, I believe if they can win week one, I think they go all the way.
Is it different footy in finals?
Yeah, it goes up a level.
Yeah. How so? Just like origin type?
Origin's physical for the whole period. This is like – it's fast. It's just really fast. It's really fast. Intense. Like origin's physical, man, and it is physical and fast, but like – you go to a next level. And I think the other thing about being in the NRL and being in, you know, playing as a team in a final, it's you don't have all those players that are classy like Origin. Mm. So it is still a bit harder because you want to go that next level, but you've still got a few that aren't there yet.
Yeah.
So you're trying to find that. And I think if we're going to put anyone in that realm, Penrith have found that Origin feel about them and they've had it for a couple of years. So I'd say that the Broncos are very close to there. And if they can, just tighten up a few defensive things, I think we'll be fine.
What the Broncos have on their side is Renault and having no one really with any finals experience in the Broncos side is except him, he'd know what to do.
Yeah, I mean, well, there's a few of those boys who have played.
They've won game.
Yeah, they've played a couple of, finals.
They got pumped.
But the other thing is you've got to take out of this year, Saucy, is that Sterling, is that they've obviously played Origin this year, a lot of those boys. Yeah, so they understand the pace, they understand what they need to do, they understand the big occasion. So it's gonna be nice to watch to see how I wanna see how Reece reacts to this because we know that he's a big game player.
Yeah.
There's just a few things that he probably needs, like the few errors, because he makes up for them. But we know that he will make up for him. Mm. Yeah. But imagine if he didn't have them in his game.
Yeah.
But look how young he is. Like this is the other thing. We got 4 more years of Payne. He's probably going to sign again too. He'll probably sign again with Payne because he's only another 2 more years. I think Reece does.
Yeah, and
and then he'll get.
He's on like
Ezra Man.
Yeah,
Ezra Man. We got to re-sign.
Yeah, and I don't think that'll be an issue because the type of person Ezra is that he won't want to leave.
Yeah.
Like you don't get many of those guys anymore.
Yeah.
These kids want to stay together.
Yeah.
Katoni's got 2 more years.
Yeah. So we've got a window.
Yeah. This is
our premiership window. Right. And if you go and win one, that's when you get worried because then they'll go, all right, well, I've won one. I want to get my pay packet.
Yeah.
So they might not. You know, they might change their mind, but it's
dynasty.
Yeah.
Herbie and Flegler, like having those two here as well. Like they've been fucking good.
I reckon Fleggy will be a bigger loss than people think.
I don't doubt that he will.
Obviously Herbie, because he scores, and everyone sees he's scoring tries and
moves. They're both big ins for them.
I love Fleggy's aggression. Love it.
Yeah.
Well, they can match Leota and Fisher Harris with Payne and Flegler. Yeah.
I cannot wait for Broncos Panthers.
Yeah. It's going to be juicy.
I hope it's the GM.
I think we meet in the grand final.
I do too.
I think we do.
I don't think the Broncos lose another game. Yeah. I've said it like 4 weeks ago.
And you know what? Everyone goes, but Penrith, It's all out the window when it goes to the
yes,
GF. The GF, yeah. When you make a GF, either team can win it.
Yeah.
You know, it's that day, it's that moment, it's a big game.
Yeah. I was there in 2015, so I need that back.
I was on the bench. I was sitting just behind the bench and I cried like a little girl.
Man. I cried.
We almost got in a fight with the under-20s Manly side.
Oh, God.
They stormed our bus because we were sad sacks
and
of
who
shit.
Was in it? Anyone else? Anyone was in it that you played or...?
No. Did they just stormed our bus because there was a bit of heckling going on?
Oh, God.
Yeah, which was not smart footy because those under-20s dudes were fucking huge.
Well, they're big boys.
Jacked up on Mountain Dew.
Oh, we were jacked up on all sorts
jacked
of things.
Jacked up on Mountain Dew.
But that was... Sean Johnson wins Dally M, you reckon?
Yeah, oh, look, I'm going to... I said at the start of the year, I'm going to stick with my pick.
Pain.
No, I went Harry Grant.
Oh.
He was behind closed doors. He was third, and Reece is out of the equation because he got suspended.
Yeah,
I'm just gonna I'm not gonna go against it, but it looks like he's come home with a wet sail. But we didn't see much of Sean. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So he's gonna make up a lot of. I know there's been a lot of talk about it, but he's gonna have to make up a lot of ground. But he has been the standout in the back end of the year.
Mm. What about Payne?
Yeah, well, Payne's up there.
Yeah,
of course he is. But I'm just gonna.
What about Paddy?
Yeah, I mean, Pat was in the... He was in the top 10, I think he was,
Didn't he win the Bronx medal?
Paul Morgan.
Yeah.
Have they done that? That was last year. Payne.
What did he win recently?
He won the...
He won State of Origin last year.
He won Wally Lewis.
Yeah.
This year it was...
This year it was Cotter.
Yeah, Ruben Cotter, yeah.
Have the Bronx... No,
they haven't had that.
I swear I saw...
They have that at the end of the year.
I swear there was something I saw on Facebook that he won some award.
No.
Might have been in my dreams.
Sexy Man Award or something like that, maybe.
Flowing wet locks.
Oh, little luscious.
Could have been.
Righto, so I've got my knob and legend of the week, Jharal.
Yeah, beauty. I've been waiting to... I've listened to all your podcasts, actually, boys.
Thanks, good.
Every single one.
And you like it?
So I'm a shareholder.
Yeah, you are a shareholder, and we appreciate that.
I love it. So I'm intrigued to see if you got this week.
You're familiar with it.
Yes.
So this week I'm going to kick off with my knob of the week.
Beauty.
Right? Now... We love refs on off-field drama. We love umpires. But in both codes this week, there was a blatant fuck-up.
Well, which code are you talking about, though?
Well, I'm going to kick off with both, NRL and AFL.
Okay, I thought you were talking about rugby.
No, we won't, mate.
We've
I know,
given that enough airtime.
I know you don't love that. No. Anyway, we'll start off with the AFL in the Crows-Swans game.
Is this the one where it goes across the line and it wasn't...
No, this is one where Ben Keys, who's actually a Brizzy boy, kicks a goal for Adelaide... Goes through, umpire calls it behind.
Yeah.
They don't review it, even though they've got the technology.
But it was past the pole, hey?
Went straight through.
It didn't even hit the post.
Hit the post.
But it went over the line, right?
Yeah.
When in the rule, do the ball have to be completely over the line?
Yeah.
Okay, it was completely over the line.
I think if it just hits the post.
If it hits the post, it's behind.
It's a behind.
But they've got Snicko like now for the pass.
Oh, like for cricket.
Yeah, and they don't even use it.
Didn't even use it.
How does that work?
A minute left and the guy goes.
We digress, but go on.
No, you're right. Anyway, the biggest thing about it is the major sponsor for umpires is OPSM.
Oh, stop it.
You know what I mean?
I do my best work with them. Yeah, I know.
They fucked up big time on the weekend. And now Adelaide Crows can't make. So that was finals implication.
Oh, shit.
So that's one of my knobs of the week because you would have hated that.
You're doubling down with two knobs.
Well, because it's umpires. Umpires.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
Then it was the 8 tackles in the Knights versus Rabbitohs game.
What's doing?
Yeah. What the fuck, man? Count.
Because this was pretty big on the Rabbitohs season.
Well, once again, finals implications. Mm. Daniel Saifidi scores on eight tackles.
Bit of a Bo Ryan
was
about
this,
it.
When was this? That was the Raiders one where they thought it was a he'd in the grand final.
In the grand,
Yeah, that's a big one. That's a
big one.
How do you fuck up 8 tackles?
Like, well, we can all count to what?
Everyone,
seven?
You remember the Bo Ryan?
Yes,
that was
correct. Seven tackles.
This is 8 tackles.
That's a lot of tackles.
He's missed 2. Like, how do you...
Was there, in their defence, was there a reset?
No, it was a 7 tackle.
Yeah,
set.
But did they call a reset and miss?
Because
I was pretty pissed by this time this game came on Saturday. Well,
you and Reedy?
Yeah.
It was a Sunday, by the way.
The red man. Oh, was it? Must have been still drunk.
Are you sure you were cracking the beers at 10:30 or Reedy was cracking the beers?
It was the red man. It was me. But that's okay. Knob of the week.
So that's my knob of the week. Now, my legend of the week, okay... It's to do with the Soccer World Cup. It's obviously been a huge success.
Don't tell me I think I know who you're going
to
say.
No, well, I'm going to give it to the Spanish side.
Yeah,
because I fucking hate England. And on this potty, we love seeing England lose.
We don't like them win at all.
We like to see them fall very far.
So bravo to this. Obviously, Matilda's a legend.
It's not coming home.
They're great. It's not coming down home. Under, and it's not coming down in. But congrats to the Spanish team. That chick that kicked the match winner.
Yep, she's 19 years old.
21, I think. Yeah.
Number 19 on her
back. Her dad died that night. So she found out after the game that her dad died. So shout out Olga. Her name is,
O-L-G-A, Olga.
O-L-G-A. So what a moment. Legend of the week. Fuck you, Piers Morgan, you fucking.
Yeah, and you know what? It sucks because Piers Morgan's an Arsenal fan and he does my head in. I don't want him to be a fan of the Gooners.
Oh, fuck him.
Yeah.
So suck a dick to all the Poms out there. Obviously the shareholder one's good on you, but
nah, fuck them too.
You fuckwits can't win a thing.
They can't. They keep falling over at the finish line.
Right, they just, I don't know what's in the air over there.
Yeah.
A lot of Aussies go over there to fucking party. I text one of the boys over there and I said, suck a dick. He was rooting for him. And they, he was rooting because he wanted the
I think once you get in the, and you want the celebration.
They wanted the Atmos, the celebration.
Because they go crazy. They would have went crazy if they'd won it.
It was coming home chance. Apparently we're flying everywhere and little too early. It's coming home chance.
Can I give a legend of the week to someone?
Yeah, far away.
Yeah, I'm going to give it to Nikki Webster.
Yeah.
Strawberry Kisses.
Yeah, I saw that.
But
that
I'm also going to give my knob of the week to her as well because she tried to sing and she was shit. She was so... No, but I could hear it. Like, she tried to sing and she definitely has lost it.
Yeah.
She's lost it. So,
Did she ever have it?
That might be the first for your drama.
Not a legend.
But she beats it both. She did it. She tried to do a great thing, but she
That shocked me that she just came on stage there.
Well, that was their song.
Was it unannounced?
Well, they didn't know she was coming. No, and she's probably a great girl.
If she just rocks
but
up.
She was not. It wasn't that great. Like,
unannounced. Oh, just like
I heard some of the girls, like Sammy Kerr, get have a crack and just stick to kicking a fucking ball from 30 feet. How far out was that?
The Strawberry Kisses. Yeah, what a song!
No one told me I've got Backstage Boys fucking doing
Blue Line Discos.
Backstage Boys.
Backstreet Boys. Anyway, next week I'm going to be looking after the off-field drama podcast because Berg's going to have a week off. He can't speak properly.
Mate, I had a red hot crack.
And you can't go to the judiciary on Tuesday to try and get through, all right?
Can't get 4 weeks.
No.
Mitchie just wanted me to ask the question and see if it was possible. And I was like, mate, you're a fucking idiot. Maybe if it was 1 week, but 4 weeks to zero is just outrageous.
Yeah, he's talking crazy.
So he might be sinking piss with me on the hill.
I think he will.
Yeah. And he'll have a red hot crack.
Fair chance.
So, yeah. I'll have him on my right and Wayne on my left. And I'll be fucking shundering by half time. Yeah, Wayne's press control. We could get him sponsoring it.
He's done my house.
Has he really?
Yeah. Won't tell the address though, because we got a stalker over it.
Mate, did you end up having more fucking insects when he left rather than when he started?
Get on your trolley.
Did you see the numbers they had did you go to a World Cup game?
Unfortunately, I didn't. I was filthy. I couldn't.
Because don't you love soccer, saying?
I love soccer. I'm a Gooner. I've been an Arsenal fan since I was about 10 years old.
But you didn't go?
No, I didn't go to this one because the reason why is because I had people. I had people at my house. So I couldn't just
fucking
leave.
Hell.
I just couldn't leave.
How long did you come up with that excuse?
Oh, I had the reeds over, the red man, so I can't just... I had the whole family, so I can't just go, right, guys, I'm put you all to bed. I'm just going to head off to Suncorp and watch this game.
Imagine if you did that. Just put them all... You look, just say, hey, I've got to go to bed.
I'd be a real piece of work.
Yeah.
Well, there's no way I could have gone to the soccer on Saturday. Nah. I was in licorice all sorts.
Does he like the soccer, Reedy?
Well, he is English.
Yeah. Well, that's why
I asked. Yeah, he's a fraud, though. He goes for Man City. He just jumped on the bandwagon. Yeah.
Can I make a quick comment? And people might laugh at this, but when Sam Kerr was running down that sideline, dribbling the ball, you know what it reminded me of? Matt Bowen taking that intercept try in Origin.
Was it the same side?
Same side, right-hand side. And the crowd just went up as one.
That was fucked.
That was
actually fucked.
Mango was my roomie for All Stars.
Was he?
Was he?
Yeah.
Why'd I call him Mango?
Bowen, mango Bowen, the Bowen.
Oh,
mango.
Yeah, Bowen mangoes. Well, I thought it just because he might have liked mangoes.
No, no, it's like, Bowen mango. So obviously like the Bowen
tinnies, like
the Bowen mango is like the one of the best mango in the world. Yeah, they still they ship them to overseas. They ship them to Mexico.
Rightfully so.
Everywhere. So he got the name because he's, you know, they're one
it's
of
the lost frogs.
It's mango. His nickname's Mango.
Yeah,
he'd be great.
Man. Can you just make it up and say that he loves sinking tinnies?
Yeah, why not? Yeah. He doesn't really drink a lot.
No?
Well, that's going to be tough to
it's going to be tough.
He just eats mangoes instead of drinking beers when you go out.
Gets meat pies and eats mangoes,
Has he put on a few?
Oh, I don't know, actually.
Yeah, you haven't seen him recently?
I haven't seen him. I still talk to him every now and then. Just he's my room dog. He's my first, like, big roomie.
Who was your best roommate you had?
Oh, man.
You had a few?
Probably Dozer.
Really?
He was a snorer, though.
Oh,
and loves and
guilty with that too.
And loves tomato sauce, like cereal, tomato sauce, anything.
Fuck off.
No, he wouldn't. But I'm just saying.
Can you imagine?
But he does screams, for his Jacob. 30th birthday. I sent him a 12 pack of tomato sauce, big bottles of tomato sauce, and he was frothing.
Really?
Yeah.
Can we get him up to the titties, the Titans?
Oh, I think that's past.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah.
I think he's going to stay at the Dragons?
I reckon he will. Yeah. Not that I want him to.
No, I'd love to see him at the Titans with Desi.
Jack White might be doing a backflip.
No. Is he?
You heard that?
No.
What?
Because, well, Rabbits aren't making finals.
He's not going to backflip.
They reckon it could be the biggest since DCE, speaking of Titans.
What about Latrell missing from right in front yesterday and hitting the woodwork?
Didn't matter, though.
Oh, man. They're just in schmozzles.
I tipped them.
The Rabbits, so did I.
I tipped the Knights.
Oh, did you? Knights?
Oh, shit, yeah, I did. I can show you the receipts.
Seven on the trot.
And Sean O'Malley.
Oh, so did I.
Paying $3 or $4 or something.
Yeah. Round two, 100 on it.
You have him for the round?
Yeah.
That's hectic.
Knockout
that
two.
Yeah.
For knockout.
I couldn't believe he was paying that much.
$12.
Yeah. No, even to win. It was like head to head. It was like $3 or something.
Yeah, something
Four
like
bucks,
that.
Full that 50 for the knockout.
Right here.
Yeah. Talk shit, get
him. He lives and breathes MMA and UFC. Oh, you look at his Instagram. He just smokes weed and fucking fights.
Yeah, I love him. Got a lot of time for him. And that was very Conor McGregor, Aldo-esque.
Yeah.
That jab. And bang.
Yeah. Good right seeing the Novocastrians doing well, by the way.
Yeah.
Just to go completely off your UFC chat there. As you boys were just getting into your work.
It's all right.
He's
no, good on
him. How many deep beers are you? Jeez.
Mate, last night I got well and truly into my work. I started here at the CACO and then ended up back at mine, bought a case of
Sunday last night. Yeah, I just drink. I'm usually drink a lot of whiskey now. Just on the rocks.
What
on
whiskey?
The rocks.
Well, my favourite whiskey at the well, not my favourite, but I'm drinking Green Label Johnny Walker.
Oh yeah,
Just on the rocks.
Yeah.
I had a few. I got a few new ones for the shareholders if they're whiskey drinkers out there. But
we love our whiskey.
Yeah, this one on
love
the weekend.
Our scotch.
Tell your shareholders, have a go at this one. Redbreast. It's called
Redbreast.
It's a single pot still whiskey, and it's an Irish whiskey. And it's amazing. 12-year-old whiskey. It's delicious.
Holy
had that on the weekend. Had half a bottle of that by myself.
Good on ya.
Had a crack and
it I love Japanese whiskey as well.
Oh yeah, Nikka. Yeah. It's beautiful.
Yeah.
Yeah, Nikka's
the Yamazaki
amazing.
And stuff. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, we're gonna have to do reviews. You just might have to review whiskey. Yeah.
That'd be fun.
And we could bring you on.
Mm.
We could drink it here. Yeah.
We were saying we should make this like not just a one-off, like we should get you in every now and then and
nice
do like some...
I mean, look, if you...
Predictions.
Or an analyst.
Yeah. Oh, I love me some analysis.
Analysis. I don't know. We were thinking about that. We're having a chat.
What is it called?
See what the shareholders reckon.
Yeah. Yes. Just give it to the shareholders.
Yeah.
I'm more than happy to, boys. I mean, look, it's I do, as you can tell, I love talking out of this thing called my mouth.
Yes.
And, I like diving deep into stuff as well, so it's a pleasure. It's a pleasure to be on here.
Righto. Well, let's finish with our favourite segment.
Okay.
This is the shareholders love this. Now I've gone back to
I saw,
which I'm not sure if we like that.
I don't mind
it. Yeah, okay. So it's our belt bender beer.
Okay. Right? Yeah. Oh yeah. Are you going to name some for me?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Bring this on.
Now, I feel like, you know, you might be familiar. This will be interesting, your take. We had Alfie. So we're going to go with the same category. So okay. Journos.
Oh, yeah.
Brent Reed, James Hooper, Buzz Rothfield.
If you threw Danny Widler in there.
I'm going to have to have a beer with Buzz because I feel like if I belted him, he'd die. Like, and actually, like... I actually think he'd be a funny yarn. Like, I actually think
he'd be so
a funny
would
yarn.
I
actually do think he'd be a funny yarn.
I love Buzz.
Who else have I got?
Brent Reed.
So what do I
and
get?
And James Hooper. So Belt Bender Beer.
Oh gosh. Oh.
So you're having a beer with Buzz.
Yep, I'm having a beer with Buzz.
Who are you belting?
Either give me the names again.
Fucking hell.
Yeah, I know.
Brent Reed or James Hooper.
Oh, okay. Oh man, this is tough.
Did you have a relationship with either of them?
Either. Neither.
No.
So it's just like, I don't know, it's a flip of the coin.
Yeah.
I don't really care.
Well, one's a Queenslander and then one's
well,
a New South Wales.
Give me who's a Queenslander?
Reed. Brent Ray.
Yeah, Reed. Give me him for a bender then.
Yeah, perfect. You're going to Belt Hooper.
Yeah. I'd definitely have a beer with
Buzz.
Yeah, because yeah, I just feel like he's a bit of older headed.
He loves his beer. He loves to sink.
Yeah, and he loves to have a punt too. Yeah. Like I know
does
he likes
he?
To go to the pub. Yeah, yeah.
Fuck yeah. He loves piss.
Yeah. So, I mean, we've seen that picture circling with him and the titty girl.
Oh, that is so good.
So he's my type of guy.
Can I throw in another journo one?
Yeah.
I said Danny Widler.
Buzz out.
Who's that fat New South Wales journo and his bald head?
Oh,
he's
man.
On the SEN with Matty Johns.
I have no clue. Yeah. Honestly, boys, I'm in the media and I don't even know who the... Like, I don't really know because I don't really listen to what they really
say. This is it. Danny Widler, Paul Kent or Brayton Astor.
Oh, well, I'm belting Paul Kent.
Oh, fuck.
That was an easy one.
He hasn't copped enough shit for what
he's done. And I'm bending with Braith.
Yeah.
Because, you know, because he's...
And have a beer with Danny.
He's a bachelor BA.
Yeah.
There's a lot of girls out there that love a piece of BA.
Yeah. Get amongst the girls.
Including
he's yourself. Single now, is he?
Yeah, he's single.
Is he? Braith.
Yeah. He's on the open market.
Where does he live?
Gee.
On a yacht.
Maroubra, probably.
Bondi.
He's a brabble.
He'd be Bondi for sure. Righto, next one, Matty John Show. Matty John's Hindy and Fletch.
Oh, God. This is hard.
Yeah. Here we go.
I'd probably... I'd probably belt Matty because I can belt him.
That's what Alfie said.
You know what I mean? Like, he'd be the only person I'd probably be able to beat out of the three of them.
You'd flog him too.
I wouldn't want to, like... You know, I'd take him out for dinner afterwards, but...
And what, with a broken nose?
Oh, I think I'm bendering with Fletch.
Couple
and
losers.
I'm having a beer with... Oh, actually, you know what? I'm probably fighting Hindy.
Really?
Yeah.
You're going to take on Tubby?
Yeah, just because, you know what? Fuck it. Just could fuck it. You know, that's why. And then I'm going to have a beer with Matty.
Have a beer with Matty.
Because I can talk some X's and O's with him. And
yeah, a bit of shape.
Ask him if I can be on the show.
I was going to say...
A lot of money.
Have you been on the show? Have you been on the Matty John
No,
show?
I haven't been on the Matty John show.
It would have started after your career.
It did,
it did.
I've been on the... Remember when Sterlo used to do his...
On the couch.
On the couch, yeah. I've been on Sterlo on the couch. I've been on the footy show.
You were on my Sterlo on the couch,
yes.
That leads us into the old school footy show, Fatty Sterlo on the Chief.
Oh, shit. Oh, well, I'm going to fight the Chief because, like, I've just got to... I have to take the biggest dog down.
Yeah.
I'm probably not going to win. And then I'm probably... bending with Fatty and having a beer with Sterlo.
Sterlo.
I actually, you know, after that interview I did with Sterlo, he did such a great job on it. I wanted to have a beer with him, but I had to leave. So, yeah, that would be my...
There you go.
That would be my three out of those boys.
That's good.
Tough. It's really tough to do that, boys.
Funny you said the exact same thing as Alf.
Did I?
I want to belt Matty and belt Chief. And he said it really quickly, like with venom, like he'd had some unfinished maybe business against both of them. I think he might have had some on field drama.
He doesn't miss Alf, I'll tell you that much. He does not miss very often. And if anyone's ever had a beer with him, any of the shareholders, if you haven't, fucking get
vodka Red Bull.
I tell you what, anything that he gives you, drink. Do not say no because you're in trouble. That's the thing I've learned about Alf. If you say no, then he's got you.
Yeah.
So if you're just confident about everything you do, and he's never going to listen to this because he doesn't know how to work his phone, just go with it.
Never tell him it's your birthday either.
No, tell him it's your birthday. It's reverse psychology with him, boys. I'm telling you, it's worked for me. The first time I was with Alf, I tried to fight him because he gave me too much drinks. Yeah, I tried to fight him at the front of the paddo, not the road.
Bullshit.
No
Did
lie.
You really?
No lie.
What
Sammy,
happened?
Sammy Thaido had to stop me.
Did you really?
Yeah, because he was
fucking
picking
Loomis.
On me. Like
Loomis.
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 Yeah. Loomis is a trick of Harry Potter, mate.
isn't it a name of a...
Loomis, so here, turn a light on.
It's a name of one of the
anyway,
characters, isn't
I still
it?
Love you, yeah. Alan Langer. And yes, if you get to have a beer with him, play the old... reverse card on him and just
reverse Uno Alf.
Yeah, reverse Uno Alf.
Reverse Uno Alf. That's great. Well, mate, what a fucking good little nudge this has been.
It's been a pleasure, boys. And, yeah, I'm more than happy to come on every now and then if you need me to. And
we don't need you. We want you.
Okay. Well, if you want me to.
Do you want us?
Yeah. I appreciate the, you know, you bring me on to the shareholders because I know it's a big deal.
Yes, thank you.
So thanks to all the shareholders for tuning in weekly.
What did you think of us? What do you think of the pod?
Yeah, it's good. I haven't stopped listening to the potty.
Yeah,
it must be all right.
Can you start sharing it to Dozer and the 20s gang?
I wouldn't go that far, Berkey.
Yeah, sweet.
When you stand out the front of my house, mate, we look, those things are not
happening. Righto, shareholders, if Jharal does something fucked, I'll give you his address.
Pleasure, Jharal.
Cheers, brother.
What a ripper.
Good boy, guys.
Cheers, mates.
Thanks, gents. What a cracker.
That was great.